Okay, it's about unhappy inpatient, and there is a patient, Miss Smithers, and she was admitted with chest infection and with suspected pulmonary embolism, and she was being treated for that along with therapeutic enoxaparin, and she was due for a CT scan of chest, and it is not done till it's now 2 days have passed, Sunday evening, and nothing has been done, and no doctor has informed her. And no doctor communicated with her, and also she has moved total of 4 times since she was admitted. So she is extremely upset about the lack of progress and lack of communication since her admission, and about moving too much, and she demands to speak to the doctor. Otherwise her observations are stable and her symptoms are completely resolved. So your task is to find out the reasons for Ms. Smith's concern and address them in a suitable manner. So as we are doing in every skill, introduction, greet, checking, identification, purpose, agenda, understanding. Okay, so like this we will do. Hello, I'm Dr. Ace, one of the doctor on call. Are you Miss Smither? Okay, nice to meet you, ma'am. Well, I understand that you were admitted with some chest infection and being treated for that. Is that correct? Correct. Okay. So I'm here to discuss with you about your condition and what we can do further and what's going on, and also to address the your concern, as nurse has told me that you want to talk to me. Okay. So before I proceed further, will you tell me that what you know about your do you have some idea why you were admitted to the hospital? What you know about your condition? So take her insight like this. Okay, now she will tell you everything, that what has happened to her. Like she will tell you that she's admitted, no doctor has communicated with her, and it is adding to her frustration, and also she's moved many times, 4 times for the bed and like this, and whatever now she tells you, listen to it patiently and with full concern, and your all body, your eyes, your everything should be with the patient, okay? And keep on expressing concerns over her concern like this. I can appreciate your concern, I can understand, yes it be very difficult, and I'm sorry if nobody has communicated like this. Like you will express your concern, and never be confrontational nor defensive, okay? If she starts to raise her voice, listen patiently and acknowledge her fears and frustration. Of course it is difficult for an it will be difficult for anyone, so you have to address her concern. And now when you have apologized, now explain her politely that I apologize that you have not been reviewed by the doctor for the 2 days, but the thing is, system is slightly different on the weekends. Now silence, see her response. And then there are only a small number of doctors on the duty who will attend to new admission and very seriously ill patient first. Okay, and also reassure her that but all patients who are admitted to us in the ward and who require frequent visits or frequent checkups, they will be seen without any delay, regardless whatever is the part of the day and which part of and which day of the week. Then again silence, see her response, and then tell her that there are systems in the place, that it is that doctors are being kept informed, and how it happens, and how it happens, tell her that the nurses keep on checking, and if there is any problem they inform the doctor immediately, and immediately doctor goes to see that serious patient. And then come to her and tell her that right now I have seen your notes, and you are doing fine, and also your symptoms are better and you have improved. And now will you allow me to tell the plan, your plan when you were admitted to us? Take her inside and tell her your plan, that you were admitted with that chest infection, but we were suspecting some blood clot in the blood channels of your lung as well. This I have explained, pulmonary embolism. Pulmonary embolism is a jargon, don't say to the patient. Rather you can say blood clot in the blood channels of the lungs. Okay, and you were given treatment for that, for both chest infection as well as for the blood clot in the blood channels. And although it was decided that the CT scan and the scan of the chest will be done, but there is reduced or less radiology staff or service on the weekend, and earliest scan could happen on the Monday unless it was clinically indicated as an emergency. And in your case, it was not an emergency, as you were already being treated for chest infection for which you were admitted, and also if it was the blood clot, so already you were put on blood thinning medication for that. Thinking of that, this I told that he was on heparin. Don't say heparin, you can say blood thinning medication. And I apologize that this fact was not mentioned to you on the Friday. And also she was not informed about the staffing level and the service on the weekend. However, promised to her that I will highlight this issue with the team on the Monday morning. And I also ensure that CT scan will be requested for the next day if possible. And reassure her that one of her team doctor will let you know as soon as possible when your scan is scheduled for. And also apologize for the fact that she had to move on the ward for to move in the ward for so many times since admission, and say that it is not acceptable to move a patient in the middle of the night unless they is clinically indicated to do so, and tell her that you will raise this issue immediately with the ward sister and bed manager, and I assure you that it would not happen again. And also please I advise you that you stay in the hospital till scan of your chest is done and the medication which are being given to you through the blood channels for your chest infection, also the course is completed. This I talk about intravenous antibiotic which she is having. And so so do the end, and you recap, patient recap, offer sports, health follow-ups, and also explain her that you will fill this in the in adverse incident form. Okay, so like this you have to carry out your skill. Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.